We all know that shortcuts are really important when it comes to working in Revit. They allow you to save so much time by accessing all of the tools and commands a lot quicker. However, what you probably don't know is that you can actually assign shortcuts to contextual commands. If you don't know what contextual commands are, well, those are the tools inside of tools inside of Revit. And if that doesn't make sense, well, don't worry. As soon as you watch this video, it will make a lot of sense. And also make sure to continue watching because I have a really important announcement coming right up. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to mention that today is the last day of the Black Friday sale on BalkanArchitect.com. If you want to get access to all of the courses for only $9, so that's a 70% discount on the monthly subscription, you can get that today. It's the last day, so make sure to use that chance to get a major discount. Also, if you want to get the lifetime subscription, well, there is a $100 discount on that, so you pay once and get access to all of the courses forever. And then also we have a 20% discount on the beginner to advanced pack and also a 10% discount on the custom cabinetry plugin. So don't miss this chance to get this amazing discount. If you want to get serious about Revit, yeah, this is the best time to buy the courses. All of the links will be up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and I have this kind of half building or something like that. And let's talk about contextual commands. So first we need to figure out what are actual commands. So here we have commands, essentially tools. So for each of these tools, you're going to notice when you hover over the tool, you get that little tool tip, you get the name, and then in parentheses, we have the shortcut for that tool if it has a shortcut. If I hover over the roof, for example, it doesn't have a shortcut, so there's no parentheses next to that name. Now, these are all regular commands. You have them here and here and here, everywhere on these tabs in the ribbon. However, when you start a certain tool, like a wall tool here, you're going to get this additional tab that appears, and it's going to be highlighted in green, and here we have some additional tools. So these are considered contextual tools. So these are only available in the context of placing a wall. You need those draw tools, but you don't really need draw tools for placing walls unless you're in the wall command. So those are the contextual tools for the wall command. Now, this is for placing a wall when you start the command. You also get contextual commands when you select elements. So if I hit the escape key a couple of times and select this roof, for example, you can see we have the contextual menu, we have modify roofs, and we have the edit footprint. That's the command or tool that's available. If I select this floor, we have even more. We have edit boundary, edit modify sub-elements, and we have all of the shape editing tools. For door, for example, we have edit family and pick new host. So these are all additional tools. And for any of these tools, we can set up shortcuts. So for example, for this wall, I use walls all the time, obviously. And then for these contextual commands, I can actually set up shortcuts for them. So for example, let's say the attached top base, this is something that I'm using often, and it makes sense to have a shortcut for that just because I don't have to always go up and find the tool and then click on it. It just wastes some time. So what I'm going to do is go here to the file menu and then open up the options, and let me drag them over. And here in the options under the user interface, we have keyboard shortcuts. And here, if I click on customize, you can customize the keyboard shortcuts. Now we have this filter, and I can just search for contextual commands. Here we go, contextual tab, and then, or contextual tabs. And then here I can search for attach. Okay, so here we have the attach top base, and this is the contextual tabs, the modify wall menu. Okay, so here I can press and enter new keys. So I can say attach top base, AT would be a good shortcut. So let's just type in AT and click on assign. And we're going to get this error message saying that this is already assigned to the air terminal. Now, This is perfectly fine if you're working with air terminals. I'm an architect and I don't really use them at all. So it makes sense for me to just turn off this shortcut for air terminals and then make it available here for the attached top base. So then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change this to all, and then let's search for air terminal. And here we have that AT shortcut. So I'm just going to click there and then click on remove to remove this shortcut. And then let's go back, search for the contextual tabs, and then let's search for the attached top base. Here we go. And then here it remembered that I wanted to add this, so I can just click on assign. Okay, it kind of gave me a warning there, but I think we're all right. So let's click OK, click OK again. And now with the wall selected, I'm just going to type in AT, and as you can see, it went into attach.base. Here we have attach wall, top is the option, and then I can just click on this roof, and it's going to attach it to that roof. So it works. Now, if I select this and if I hover over attach.base, you can see we have that AT shortcut appearing there. So that's basically how you can assign these shortcuts even to these contextual commands, so you can work as fast as possible using shortcuts pretty much all of the time. And finally, just one more thing to show you is that if you set up your shortcuts, you customize them however you like, and then you have to perhaps reinstall Revit, go to a home computer or something like that, you're going to be working on a different machine or you're updating to a newer version, it makes sense to save those shortcuts so you don't have to redo all of your work. So to save the shortcuts, or actually to export them, you go here to File, you go to Options, you then go to User Interface, and then open up or customize keyboard shortcuts. And here you have your list, obviously, which we've changed, and then we have the export button. So here you can just export this, and it's going to export those shortcuts, as you can see, as an XML file. Now, I'm not going to export these, however, you can, and then on a different machine or a newer version of Revit, you would simply click on import to bring those back in, and then you can use your customized shortcuts inside of Revit. Okay, I hope you have learned something new. Tell me in the comment section below, is this something that you have used before? And also don't miss out on the Black Friday offer. If you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, like this project file, as well as all of my other project files, well, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.